Consider the following exercises. Find the mean for each group of data items. Number one, find the mean for the data 1, 3, 5, 10, 8, 5, 6, 8. As a review, the mean is computed by adding all the data entries and divide it by the total number of data entries. So in this case, the mean is just equal to 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 10 plus 8 plus 5 plus 6 plus 8. Divide this sum here by the number of data entries, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have 8 data entries. Adding the numerator, that is equal to 46 divided by 8, that gives us 5.75. Next, we will find the mean for this group of data. To find the mean, we will just add all the data entries. So we have 1.4 plus 2.1 plus 1.6 plus 3.0 plus 1.4 plus 2.2 plus 1.4 plus 9.0 plus 9.0 plus 1.8 and divide it by 10, which is equal to the number of data entries in the given set. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 data entries. So summing up the numerator, that is equal to 32.9 divided by 10, and this is just equal to 3.29. Next, we will consider the given frequency distribution table here, and we will find the mean for the data items. So to find the mean, we will have to create another column here, and this column here would represent the product of the score and the frequency. Multiply x and f. For the first row, x times f, so we have 1 times 3, that is equal to 3. Next, 2 times 4, which is equal to 8. And then for this next row, we have 3 times 6, that is equal to 18. And then we have 4 times 8, which is equal to 32. 5 times 9, which is equal to 45. 6 times 7 is equal to 42. 7 times 5, that is equal to 35. 8 times 2 is 16. 9 times 1, which is equal to 9. And 10 times 1, which is equal to 10. Then the next step is to add the column here. So let's add products here. We have 3 plus 8 plus 18 plus 32 plus 45 plus 42 plus 35 plus 16 plus 9 plus 10. That is equal to 218. We will also add the frequency. So adding the column here would give us n. So the total frequency, if we add 3 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus 9 plus 7 plus 5 plus 2 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 46. So therefore, the mean for this frequency distribution table here is just equal to the summation of the product of x and f divided by n. This summation of the product of x and f is just equal to 218, and n is equal to 46. So 218 divided by 46 is approximately equal to 4.74. Now for this next set of exercises, we will find the median for each group of data items. So let's consider the first group here. To get the median, it is important that we arrange the data first. So customarily, we arrange it from smallest to largest, but you can also arrange it from largest to smallest if that is your preference. In this case, we will just arrange it from smallest to largest. Arranging the data set 0, 0, then followed by 1, 2, 4, 6, and then 11, 12. Take note that the number of data items is equal to 9, and that is odd. If we have odd number of data items, the median is just the middle term. In this case, the middle number will be the fifth number. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The answer here is 2. Now consider this data set here. Let's find the median. Again, the first step is to arrange the data entries. We have 1, 3, 5, 5, 6, 8, 8, 10. Next step is to count the number of data items. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, which is an even number. Therefore, the median will be the average of the two middle terms. How would you know what is the middle term? Well, you can just get the number of data items and divide it by 2. In this case, 8 divided by 2 is equal to 4. Two middle terms here, 5 and 6, will get the average. So the median is the average of the two middle term. So that is 5 plus 6 divided by 2. And that is equal to 5.5. So another example, let's consider this data set here and find the median. The first step is to arrange the data items from smallest to largest. So we have 1.6, 2.5, then 2.5, 2.7, 3.2, 3.6, 3.8, 4.2, 4.2, 4.7, 5.0. Next is to count the number of items. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, which is odd. So therefore, the median is just the middle term. So what's the middle term for 11 items? So how would you know that? You just have to divide 11 by 2, and that is equal to 5.5. So therefore, it will be the sixth data entry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 3.6. For this next set of data items, let us arrange first the data entries from smallest to largest. We'll have 1.4, 1.4, then 1.4. 1.6, 1.8, 2.1, 2.2, 3.0, 9.0, and 9.0. Since we have even number of terms, we will just have to get the average of the two middle terms. The two middle terms are 1.8 and 2.1. How did I know that? Since I have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 10 data entries, and that is even, if I divide that by 2, I'll get 5. So that means the fifth and the sixth data entries will be the middle terms. So I'll get the average of those two. So you have 1.8 plus 2.1, divide that by 2, I'll get 1.95. In this next exercise, we are given a frequency distribution table and we are to find the median for the data items. For this particular problem, I'm going to use the position formula to find the median of the data. Since the data is already organized, the first step is to just add the frequency. By adding the frequency, we get the total number of data entries. So if I'm going to add 2 plus 4 plus 5 plus 7 plus 6 plus 4 plus 3, that gives me 31. Notice that this is an odd number. We still use the same principle. If the number of items is odd, the median is the middle term. To locate the middle term, we will use the position formula. The position formula is given by n plus 1 over 2, where n is the number of data entries. So in this case, this is just equal to 31 plus 1 divided by 2, and that gives us 32 over 2, which is equal to 16. So therefore, the 16th position is the median. To determine the 16th position, we will just count down in the frequency column. We start with 2 and then add 4, we get 6, plus 5, we get 11, and then plus 7, that is equal to 18. So therefore, the 16th position will be somewhere here. So the 16th position will be obtained after you get the 11th position, and you just add 5, and that falls under this row here. So therefore, the 16th position is 4. Now let's consider the case wherein the sum of the frequency is equal to an even number. If I'm going to add this column here, the frequency would total to 46. If I'm going to find the median here using the position function, then I will have to add n plus 1 and then divide it by 2. I'll have 46 plus 1 divided by 2. That gives me 47 divided by 2, which is equal to 23.5, which means that the median is the mean of the data items in positions 23 and 24, because we have even number of entries here. From our discussion, if the number of entries is even, it is just equal to the average of the two middle terms. To locate the 23rd and the 24th position, we will just count down in the frequency column here. So we have 3 plus 4, that is 7, plus 6 is equal to 13, plus 8, it's 21, plus 9, that would be 30. So the 23rd and the 24th position are on this row here. Both are equal to 5. The median is equal to 5 plus 5 divided by 2 equals 5.